Hi, my name is Cindy. I'm from the Dell networking team. Today we are going to update the Dell switches from 10.5.17 to 10.5.24. Before we get started, I'm going to point out that we need to reference the support matrix. The support matrix will show all the versions that you should be on for that baseline. Today, we are going to 10.5.24, which means OMEM should be on 1.30.00. In my chassis, we are already on 1.30.00. Normally, we could download the package on support.dell.com, but starting on 10.5.24, the update package is actually available through the MX catalog. So we're going to go ahead and log in. So once you're in OMEM, you're going to want to create a catalog. So you're going to go to Configuration, Firmware Compliance. Once in Configuration, Firmware Compliance, you're going to click on Catalog Management, and we're going to add a catalog. You have several options. Because the MX is very baseline oriented, I'm going to choose Validate Firmware Solution Baseline on Dell.com. I'm going to choose manually, but you do have the option to choose automatic. I'm going to go ahead and click Finish. Once our catalog is finished, it's already pulled the latest version, but for future reference, you could click Check for updates, and it will download any updates that are available. So we're going to return back to Firmware Compliance, and we're going to create a baseline. We're going to choose the Dell networking baseline we created, and then we're going to name the baseline. We're going to choose the catalog we created, and then we're going to name the baseline. We're going to go ahead and click Next. Now, it doesn't matter which one you choose. You could do it by the device, or you could do it by groups. Either option, you're going to choose Network IOM. And under this section, you're going to go ahead and choose your switches. In our case, we are upgrading the MX9116Ns. So I'm going to go ahead and choose the A1 and A2 that I have in my chassis. Go ahead and click Finish, and then click Finish again. Once the baseline has been created, you could view the report from here. So you could select your baseline and then click View Report, and then you could look at the items that are in it. You could see that we are currently on this version, and the baseline version is going to be 10.5.2.4. From here, we're going to go ahead and kick off the update. So we're going to go to Devices, IO Modules, and we're going to select one of our switches. Because these switches are in SmartFabric, we don't need to select both switches. We just need to select one of the SmartFabric switches, and it will push the updates to the other switch that's in SmartFabric. From here, we're going to go ahead and click Update. We're going to select the baseline, and you could see here when we reviewed, it's the same kind of view. So, and it's already selected, so we don't have to do anything else, but click Next. We can schedule updates. In our scenario, we are going to update now rather than schedule later. And the server options, we simply ignore because we're updating switches. Go ahead and click Finish, and then Yes. And the job is submitted. So to review, or I guess monitor the job, you would go to Monitor Jobs, go ahead and view details on that running job. And in this window, if you scroll down a little bit, it's going to send the Dell update package, and it's gonna start the process. As you can see, it's running. This process can take anywhere between 30 and 120 minutes. Usually you just sit and let it complete. Or if you're like myself, go into the switches and you start seeing what's actually going on. The Dell update packages will get pushed to the image directory on the switches. When the package is done uploading or downloading to the switch, it's going to appear in the image directory. I'm going to give it a few minutes and then we can look to see where the packages are. The switches are going to update the Smart Fabric backup node first, and you could identify which node that is by doing show Smart Fabric cluster. A1 is currently the backup and A2 is the master. So the first switch that will get an update is going to be the A1. As we can see here, the transfer progress, it completed 100%, and we are currently on package 3 of 9 in the install. And you can see the installation state is at install. And if we go ahead and look at the other switch, you could see that nothing has started. Also good information. If you look at your image directory, you will see the file is transferred there. It's not quite the name that is recognizable when you download the bin file from Dell. Usually it has a user-friendly name, but this is the file. It's the bin file. We can sit here and watch the upgrades as they happen. It will take quite some time. It's average 20 minutes per switch, but again, we like to say it's anywhere between 30 minutes to 120 minutes. If you're only looking at OMEM, you do see that it's upgrading that node that we're looking at. So we're just going to allow this update to finish. So I do see that one of our switches has reloaded. I'm going to go ahead and log in and take a look. And there we have it. We're on 10.5.2.4 on one of the switches. This switch is currently the backup. We currently see all our networks. And we do see that our VLTI link is up. I'm going to go ahead and look at our other switch. So we do see that the image is present. And we do see that we're on 5 of 9 of the update. And if we look at OMEM, it does say that the other one has started. The second switch rebooted and it is back up. Let's go ahead and take a look at it. We do see that we are on the latest version, 10.5.2.4. And check out Smart Fabric Cluster. This is now the backup. I'm going to check out the VLT. It appears that we are on the latest greatest. We're going to go check now in OMEM. It shows the job status is finished and completed. We're going to scroll back up to the top. And there we go. We see it's completed and it was completed with no errors. And to go ahead and look at the versions in OMEM, we should be able to see it once it loads. There we go. There's A1. We could go to A2. And there it is. And that concludes our video. Have a great day, everyone.